Hello everyone, it's Brenda Douglas, your real estate notary and title expert. Welcome to my channel. Here is where I introduce you to DMV, which is also known as the District of Columbia, Maryland, and Northern Virginia. The DMV attracts more than 18 million tourists every year, which makes it one of the most fun places to work, live, and visit. Listen, now that you're here, go ahead and subscribe to this channel for more fun things to do around the DMV, such as community events, tourist attractions, family fun activities, real estate related topics, and so much more. One of the advantages of residing in the District of Columbia or the DC metropolitan area is that you get to enjoy so many community events. Okay, and we also have many different types of annual festivals all throughout the District of Columbia, Maryland, and Virginia, including the Cherry Blossom Festival, guys. We have the Book Festival, where you can come and meet all kinds of authors, okay, or aspiring authors. We have cultural festivals. We have jazz festivals, folklife festivals, pride festivals, and so many more, okay? Listen, you are never alone here in the DMV because there is always something to do. Guys, there's always something to do. In this video, we are going to be visiting the Cherry Blossom to see if whether or not they are we're going to see if they bloomed, okay? And then I'm going to share some information about some of the things that are happening to celebrate the annual Cherry Blossom Festival here in Washington, D.C., okay? But before we get started, let me give you a brief history about the cherry blossoms and, you know, because I know some of you will wonder, well, what's the big deal about cherry blossoms? Well, excuse me, the cherry blossom trees were introduced to the U.S. from Japan by Eliza Skidmore, okay? She was a writer, a photographer, a geographer, and she served as the first woman on the board of directors at the National Geographic Society, okay? She fell in love with the cherry blossom trees, and she had a passion. She developed a passion for the Asian culture, okay? And that inspired her to push for the importation of cherry trees to the U.S. Okay, so she started a cherry tree project, right? In which she would exhibit the trees, right? So that she can gain admirers or, I guess, support in her venture, okay? So so she succeeded. And in 1912, Japan offered 3,020 cherry trees And Japan offered 3,020 cherry trees of different types, of different varieties, okay, to the First Lady Taft. She's the wife of President Taft, okay? And he offered the First Lady 3,020 cherry blossom trees on behalf of Tokyo, okay? So that's how the cherry blossom trees imported here to the U.S. Today, the trees planted all throughout the District of Columbia, Maryland, and Virginia, including along the Potomac River, okay? So I am, again, going to share some of the things that are going to be some of the ways in which the Cherry Blossom Festival, as you guys know, we're still in the midst of this pandemic. And so we are still having to practice social distancing. The parade is canceled. We usually have a Cherry Blossom Parade. It's usually a big deal. You have to pay for the tickets, but it's usually a really big deal. And so people come from all across the world to take part in this celebration and in the many different activities throughout the DMV. And so I'm going to be sharing some of those activities or some of the things that we're doing now. Just know that because of the pandemic, some of the events will be held online and some are virtually. And so some of them are in person, but you still have to practice social distance. And so, as I said before, the parade was canceled. It was actually virtual, so it wasn't canceled. It was virtual, okay? So it starts, the Cherry Blossom Festival starts March the 20th, and it goes through March the 11th, okay? And the peak season for the cherry blossoms is April the 2nd through the 7th. Now, I went down to, so we're going to take a trip, I should say, to downtown so we can see, find out the status of these cherry blossoms, okay, since we're so close to April, okay? And in the meantime, I'm going to give you some, here are some things that you can take part in or some activities that you can do during the annual, the cherry blossom.
So, I was sort of bored. And so I packed up the little twosome. Say hello, hello. I don't know if you guys can see it because the camera's not turned right. But we decided to come on out here to the National Mall when I am bored or when I am stressed. This is the perfect place for me to come and just unwind and enjoy the day. As you can see, there are lots of people out here riding bikes, flying kites. I really came down here to see if there were any cherry blossoms. Let me see if I can get a good view here. And we are like on the other side of the National Monument, Washington Monument. People are riding scooters, riding bikes, like I said, flying kites. So we're gonna go over here and try to find us, try to see if the cherry blossoms are out. Yes, I know that they typically peak April the 2nd through the 7th, and it's still a little early here. But while we're out here, we're gonna go ahead over there and take a look. Oh, there's a whole bunch of them riding together. It is a beautiful day, and people are really, really taking advantage of it. Anyway, we're down here at the National Mall. So I will let you guys know if I see anything in terms of cherry blossoms, any of them blooming. Right now, as you can see over here, sometimes they're usually some over here. But as you can see, I see the little buds, but they haven't blossomed yet. So we, Cody, say hi. That's Cody. So we are going to enjoy this day. So I will show you guys some sights. This is one of the wonderful things about living down in DC or the DMV area, is because there's so much to do down here. We got people riding against Segways and then bikes and scooters, flying kites. When I'm all done with this, we're gonna ride around so you guys can see. Hopefully you can see what people are doing. But yeah, it's a beautiful day. And people are certainly taking advantage. So me and my little pupsos here, see that little buggy? Let me show you. And I'm sorry guys, I can't turn the cart around. I can't turn the camera around, but we are gonna go for a walk. Cody wants to get out. He probably sees another dog somewhere. Yep, they're out here. Anyway, stay tuned. All right, let me see if I can. This is how it is. You see people walking and riding. Gonna continue our walk over there by that water. Okay guys, so we have made it to the Tidal Basin, and as you can see, as I've stated before, nothing has really blossomed yet. I don't know if you can see that. They have not blossomed yet, but in a few weeks, like I said, the peak season is April, well, when they blossom the fullest is going to be April the 2nd through the 7th. I'm sorry, my dog sees another dog again, so we're going to move over here. So right now, I'm at the Tidal Basin, guys, and usually what happens, let me pull over to the side and pour the stroller over. So usually what happens is that all throughout, during the cherry blossom season, which is from now through April the 11th, what usually happens is that there are events all across the Washington, D.C. area. And then there's also a time where, well, this stays open. We are at the Tidal Basin. Let me see if I can flip this. I don't think I can. We are at the Tidal Basin, so I'm going to have to turn the camera around. Okay. Let me walk over here. This is the same image that is on my thumbnail, and that's the Tidal Basin over there. Well, usually what happens is there are events all across the Washington, D.C. area, and then people come down here to where the Tidal Basin is, and they just enjoy the blossoms, the cherry blossoms. There are also all kinds of events, including a parade. This year, 2021, some of the events are virtual because of COVID. And then some of the events are still taking place. But of course, with everybody practicing social distancing. So I just wanted to come down here. I've been down here where it's peak season. I have the pictures. One of them is on the thumbnail. And the cherry blossoms are usually really, really in full peak, but it is too early. It is too early, although the festivals have begun. I don't know. I'm sorry, guys. Yeah, there we go. Yeah, there we go. So nothing has come open yet. But they will be soon, okay? So we're just gonna enjoy the rest of the day. I'm gonna take the little pupsos around. And then I'm going to put some information in, as far as the events that we usually have here in the Washington, D.C. area. I'm going to put that in the comments for you to see. Okay? So we are on the other side of the Washington Monument. I see those vendor trucks are still out there, or them food trucks. Food trucks is what they are. I see they're still lined up. COVID is not stopping now. That over there is the African American Museum. And like I said, people are just out here enjoying themselves. People actually can go at the top of that. I'm sure it's not right now due to COVID, but you are actually able to take an elevator. The line is usually wrapped around that building, and you can take it all the way up to the tip of the monument. But it is a beautiful day, guys. And people are riding their bikes, their scooters. Actually, scooters that you can rent from the city too, and Segways. Another wonderful perk of living in a DMV area. All right, we're gonna continue our walk. Let me tell you, when you are downtown, every now and then you'll look up and you will see someone on the corner playing music. And we are also closer to the African American Museum. But every now and then you'll see some local talent up ahead and on the corners, especially in like Chinatown. You'll see people playing instruments. As I said, people are just out here enjoying the weather. I'm gonna go on this other side. It's always a line for the bathroom. Oh, that's a store. Oh, no, it's not. It's closed. It's closed due to COVID. I'm gonna sit down for a second. Or maybe I'll go out. Yep, I'll let you guys see the local talent. My dog is still whimpering. I'm gonna let him out for a while. He's excited. Uh-oh, is he gonna play another one? Guys, I'm walking and try to stare at the thing. Just over that way is the museum. The Smithsonian National Museum. A mall, I should say. And it stretches from the monument to the Capitol, 2 miles. 2 miles. So sometimes people come out here, even during the, especially during the summer nights, and walk. I don't know if you can see the Capitol over there. Let me see if I can. That little white spot. But from the Capitol to the monument, it's 2 miles. And so people come out here during the summer and walk. This is the DC life. Sorry, my dog sees another dog. Cody, cut it out. You're not getting to the dog. Thank you. wants to get out so bad. I'm at one more Cody. I'm gonna let them out for a while. Now wait until a few weeks during the cherry blossom parade. Actually during the celebration festival, that is. What a wonderful way to end the day. Oh, he's packing up his instruments. We came just in time. Oh wow, there's a lot of people over there walking the National Mall. We never made it over there. Or maybe we should go to the National Mall. Ah. This is absolutely beautiful. I think I want a picture of that sunset. As you guys can see, we're on the other side of the monument now. Well, the side with the National Mall. I wanted to show you that. From the monument into the Smithsonian Mall. There's the Capitol down there. From the Capitol. And these are all museums in between. These are all Smithsonian museums on both sides. So you can spend the day. This is a 2-mile stretch. You can spend the day going from one museum to the other. Once it opens, I'm sorry. It's closed due to this COVID. But that is the Capitol building down there. Again, these are all museums along this stretch. And then on the other side here, it's the Washington Monument and the African American Museum. So you can spend the entire day in this one area. Before COVID, there were games going on, people playing volleyball. I did see some people playing volleyball on the other side. But of course, things have slowed down tremendously. But when it gets warm out, it's gonna be extremely crowded down here because it usually is. And like I said, it's great to just come out here and just unwind, enjoy the night air. And like I said, you can go from museum to museum. Just checking out all the scenes and just being among people.
The Tidal Basin is not the only place where you can see the cherry blossom trees. They are, again, scattered all throughout the District of Columbia, Maryland, and Virginia, okay? You can find cherry blossom trees at the U.S. National Arboretum in Northeast Washington, D.C. You can find them at the Gardens of Dumbarton Oaks in Georgetown, which is in Washington, D.C. You can find cherry blossom trees at the Basilica of the National Shrine of the Immaculate Conception, which is in Northeast Washington, D.C. That was a long name. Okay, and you can also find them at the National Harbor in Oxon Hill, Maryland. You can also find cherry blossom trees in Arlington at the Arlington National Cemetery in Arlington, Virginia, and Alexander Bell Drive in Reston, Virginia, and other places. Like I said, most of the activities are virtual. However, there are some activities that are taking place that are in person, okay? I want to back up and say something about the parade. Even though the parade, the big parade, and what I mean by that is when the bands come and the people are wearing the costume, you know, the big major parade, sort of like the Macy's parade. They have one here for this cherry blossom parade. Well, that has been canceled. However, what they are doing in place of that is sort of doing a social distance and parade. And what they are doing is encouraging people to decorate their porches and their, so they register saying that they want to participate. And then they decorate their front yard. They decorate their front yard with cherry blossom-related type themes, I guess. And they decorate their porch. And so as people are driving through the neighborhood and coming through the neighborhood, they are able to see the different decorations. And what they've done is when people register, they create a map so that people can get this map. And they can go and visit each one of the homes that have the decorations. So that's what they're doing in place of the major parade that they usually have. So that big, big parade, it would have happened already. Like I said, everything started yesterday, which is March the 20th. Anyway, so in place of this major parade, they are having what they call petal porch parades, okay? And I'm going to give you guys a website that you can go to, look for it in the comments for you to find different activities that you can do all throughout DC. Most of it, like I said, is virtual. Some of them you will have to pay, but they're virtual. And then they have some in-person activities. For example, they're having the downtown DC's chalk walk, which is in Gallery Place, okay? And people are able to, I guess, design something on the sidewalk and then snap a picture and then send it in, I guess, to be displayed, okay? So again, all of these activities started on March the 20th, and I guess they're gonna go through, it ends like in April the 11th, okay? So you have the Gallery Place Chalk Walk, and that's on 7th Street Northwest between 7th and G and 7th and H, okay? So they're having that where you can actually go in person and take part in the celebration, okay? Then they have what's called Art in Bloom, okay? And what that is similar to a scavenger hunt. Again, there are art decorations, cherry blossom decorations all throughout the DC area, okay? And so it's sort of like a scavenger hunt where you have to find what those displays. They're like 25 different cherry blossom displays, okay? And you pretty much go throughout the city and you find where these sculptures are, okay? And I would suppose you can submit them, or I'm not sure how it has it arranged, but again, I'm going to give you the website where you can get more information about that. But listen, I just wanted to make it clear that there are cherry blossoms all throughout the District of Columbia, Maryland, and Northern Virginia. I don't know if I mentioned the National Harbor, but they also have an exhibit in addition to the cherry blossom trees that you can see in that area. You can also go and see the cherry blossom exhibit, okay? So that's at the National Harbor in Oxon Hill, Maryland, okay? Not far from the MGM studio or casino. So anyway, guys, I hope that this has been helpful. Again, I'm going to leave the link to, you know what? I forgot to mention my favorite, which is the kite flying activity that they do down on the mall. Yes, they are encouraging social distances. But what this is, guys, I get excited about this, is people come to the National Mall, which is on the video. They go to that area and they fly their kites. Oh my goodness. It's over by the monument. And so when you go out, I'm going to, you know what? I'm going to try to get out there. So they have this, did I write down when that date is? Anyway, the festival is starting now. I didn't write it down. So anyway, again, you're going to be able to go to this website and find it out. But there's a kite flying festival. And let me tell you, there are usually tons of people out there. What you do is you buy your kite and you bring it to the monument. And so when you go out there, there's so many people out there flying their kites, their families teaching their kids how to fly kites. It is just a beautiful, beautiful sight to see. So many kites flying, big, small, you know, fancy kites. So they have a particular day, and it's in the, I'm going to put it in the link, but they have a particular day in which it is a kite flying day, and it's on the National Mall. Now, they are encouraging people to stay away and to do it in their own space, in their own backyard. So, you know, I don't know how it's going to go this year, but they are encouraging people to do it in their backyards, not necessarily on the mall. But when we, as you can see from that video, there was quite a few people there. But anyway, so we will see. Otherwise, mostly all of the events are virtual. But guys, I hope that this has been helpful. I'm going to leave this information as well as the website for the National Cherry Blossom Cherry Blossom Festival. I'm going to leave that link in the comments, as well as another link where you can find other activities throughout the DC area, including the Cherry Blossom Festival. Okay, this festival again runs from March the 20th through April the 11th, and it's just a time where we pretty much enjoy the beauty of the cherry blossoms blossoming. It's like they only blossom during this one time of year. And so it's the beauty of it coming alive that we enjoy, okay? So listen, I hope that this video has been helpful to you. I'm Brenda Douglas, your real estate notary and title expert. And listen, go ahead, don't forget to subscribe to this channel, okay? And listen, whether you're buying a home or selling a home, keep your head up, your hopes high. And remember that it is not over until the keys are exchanged. Have a blessed day.